Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Shreyas. So this is the first Q&A video for 2017, and I think you guys should like my Facebook page, Shreyas Kamath Fitness. All links are in the description box, and also follow me on Instagram and all other social medias if you guys want to know or get or stay in touch with my fitness goals. Anyways, I posted a thread on Facebook and I got around 59 questions. So that is what this is. It is my new Facebook page by the name Shreyas Kamath Fitness. So all my updates are going to be on that page. So before that, I also like to thank Men's XP page for featuring my transformation on their website. I'll be dropping the link in the description box below. Basically, it has everything. I have mentioned everything, my whole journey so far. So you can check that out. So I'll be trying to answer most of the questions. The first question I'm picking is how to reduce belly fat. Now, my dear friend, again, I have repeated this 100 times. Now, when you are talking about fat, your body deposits fat all over your body. Now, if you are someone who has skinny arms and all your fat is deposited only in your belly area, it means that you have fat in your belly area. So you can't do crunches and get rid of it. Remember that you can't spot reduce fat. But what you can do is you can reduce overall body fat. Now, if you have only fat in your belly and majority of your fat is covered around your abdomen and your core, then of course you will lose fat from that area. But do not sit and perform hundreds of crunches thinking that crunches will directly burn all the fat. So I'm really sorry, you just need to be on a caloric deficit, add some cardio and just emphasize on weight training as well. So that is how you burn belly fat. And I hope that you share this information with all the people who have similar questions. Okay. Prince Shiv asks, when is Inspirein launching, brother? Who are the athletes of Inspirein? Now, as you all know, Inspirein is an apparel brand. I own that. Now I own it with my brother, so my younger brother. So it's a private limited company. It is going to launch in a couple of months. Okay. Now I'm really sorry that it has been taking a long time, but there were many things behind the scenes which are not necessary to come out. But I must say that, you know, maybe the quality check was not something that we did in the right way. So now everything is good. I like this t-shirt. You guys can check out Inspirein on Instagram as well. So it is coming out. And who are the athletes? Now, the goal with this brand, you know, is not only to sell clothes. Okay, every brand says the same thing, but the goal is to, you know, help out or get people or get natural bodybuilders or natural athletes who I know. Okay, I'm not going to check someone's Instagram and be like, okay, he's natural. No, I will try to meet people. I'll try to connect to a lot of aspiring natural fitness athletes, and that is how I'll be trying to get in athletes. I won't be like, oh my God, look at his physique. Not going to do it like that. So I want people who have a story who can inspire other people. Okay, because I actually can use my own social media to promote Inspirein, but I really want to help out, you know, people. Okay, and of course I'm not going to sell my clothes for free, but you know what I mean, right? I want people who can inspire others. Okay, that is the goal. Dev Prasad asks, is my question is whether slow cutting or fast cutting is more good, and how can we minimize the muscle loss while cutting? Your question itself has the answer. Now, fast cutting, okay, if you are an obese person who has like 40 kgs of fat to lose, you can lose like 3 kgs in a week for the first few weeks. That is fast cutting. But if you are cutting slow, it means that you are forced to cut slow. Your body doesn't have that amount of fat to lose like 3 kgs in a week. So if you are like at 15% body fat and you lose 3 kgs in a week, it really means that you are losing out on muscle. Because you should remember that your body will try to burn muscle. Okay, your body is not meant to hold on to a lot of muscle. So your body will try to hold on to more fat as you get leaner and leaner. So for people who are already lean, I would suggest to go on a slow cut. But if you are someone who has like 40 kgs or 30 kgs to lose, then I think, you know, you can cut maybe a little bit faster, because your body doesn't like to hold too much of fat as well, right? So your body will always tend to hold on to fat that will keep you, which is necessary for the normal functioning of your body. So remember that too much fat and too less fat can be the same. Like, people who have too much fat can burn fat faster. People who have very less fat or moderate amount of fat will take more time to cut. So keep that in mind. Sushil Hombali, What's your opinion on AM PM workout? Can doing cardio at PM every day is okay for fat loss goal? Okay. AM PM workout, like there were times in my last cut where I did workout weight training in the morning and cardio at night and vice versa. Like sometimes I used to do cardio in the morning and weight training in the night. That is because I had a treadmill at my home. Now I don't have access to that. To be honest, guys, I don't know why will you go to the gym twice a day, because I mean most of the gyms don't allow that, but if your gym allows that, go for it. But weight training twice a day for a longer period of time, that is not something that I would recommend, because it's better to, you know, put your full effort in the morning workout or evening workout and not like both. It's like you won't be able to progress. This is just my opinion, and there have been a lot of data that says that, you know, you can do both and get the same results, but I mean I'm not that addicted to the gym that I want to go to the gym twice a day. Okay, so that is my simple answer. Jimit Talekar asks, does masturbating affect our goals? Like, what is your goal? To masturbate more? Okay, just kidding, guys. Like, if your goal is to build muscle, I mean, that masturbation won't affect you in any way. Like, if your testosterone levels are very low, in the first place, you wouldn't feel like masturbating all the time. That is the first thing. Second thing is, even if you masturbate, come on, like, if you masturbate and go to the gym, and maybe that is not the most optimal thing to do, but if you masturbate twice a day or even 4 times or 5 times or 6 times or 7 times or into 2 times a week, I don't think there is any issue with that. Come on, and when you are young, when you are single, that all these things happen, right? Maybe once you get into a relationship, you wouldn't bother about that. But I think you don't have to worry. You need to worry about how to work out and how to diet rather than thinking about how to not masturbate. So this is just my opinion, but I think you should take my opinion. Hariharan asks, how often should one change the workout routine, or progressive overloading is enough? Now look, guys, I will categorize people into two. Okay, one is beginners who have been training for less than 2 years, and then people who are training for more than 2 years. Now for people who are training less than 2 years, you will automatically gain strength, right? Strength gaining and muscle building is easier. So of course, for you, progressively overloading is the main thing that you should keep in mind. Your goal should be just gaining strength. So for the first 2 years, just prioritize on, you know, gaining strength. And after that, maybe you should worry about changing intensity levels, like, you know, periodizing your programs, and which I will talk about, you know, in the coming videos. But for the first 2 years, just do your basic compound movements and, you know, add a little bit of isolation exercises. I have a video for beginners. You can watch this here, a free workout plan as well. But I think you said it right. Like, I think you should concentrate on progressively overloading. Once you get advanced and things starts going down, that is when you should start varying intensity and volume. Okay, till then you are fine. Praveen S. Nair, I think I should make a video on this, like how to maintain diet. Case, his case is that, you know, he is doing rotational shift, night shift, day shift, night shift. So maybe week 1 he's doing night shift, week 2 he's doing day shift, week 3 is doing night shift again. This can really be bad. I'll tell you why. Now when you work out in the morning and you're used to working out in the morning, and suddenly you change into the evening workouts, your body will take a couple of days to, you know, understand that. So for 7 days you work out in the morning, then Monday you come back to the gym in the evening, and your body is like, oh my god, you feel like you are not able to work out. So that is your body's natural tendency, because body is being used to maybe waking up in the morning and going to the gym, or even, as you know, you eat 3 meals in a day and or versus eating 1 meal in a day. So it can be very bad, but you have to get it done, because maybe your job, you have to adjust, you know. Fitness is a part of your lifestyle. For Praveen, who I have met, by the way, I have met Praveen. So fitness is a part of your life. Fitness is not your life. So you have to give priority to your work and then adjust your training routine accordingly. Maybe you don't have to go to the gym 5 times a week. Have a full body workout 3 times a week. So adjusting things like this is very important. Mayur Prabhu asks a very important question. Is 1 gram protein per pound of body weight really required for building muscles? Don't you think it's way too much? Now it can be way too much, I'll tell you when. Now let's assume I am 30% body fat, 30, and I'm around 100 kgs. So what is 100 into 2.2? It's 220, right? So do I need 220 grams of protein to build muscle? Okay, at 30% body fat, I have a lot of fat in my body, right? So I wouldn't require 220 grams of protein, especially if I'm a beginner. But if a person is 100 kgs and he has only 15% body fat, maybe then he might require that much of protein because the amount of muscle mass is more in his body. So I hope that you get what I'm trying to say here. But there have been a lot of studies done and they found out that 0.8 grams of protein per pound of body weight or 1 gram of protein per lean body mass is more than enough. Okay, 0.8 gram of protein per pound of body weight or 1 gram of protein per lean body mass is more than enough. So I think you should go by that. Sandeep Jawalagi asked, can we skip BCAs on arm day? Okay, can we skip BCAs on arm day? In the first place, like for example, if you are using whey protein before your workout, you wouldn't even need BCAs. Okay, because whey protein contains BCAs or BCAAs, okay, branched chain amino acids. Now, if you have an arm day, it means that you are taking your arm day seriously. So even though I don't recommend BCAs, if you want to take BCAs, why not take it on arm day as well? Like all muscles should be important, right? So just why ignore biceps or why just ignore arm day? So I'm just giving an answer to your question. Can we skip BCAs on arm day? Yes, no, you don't have to skip because it's just like saying, you know, you have your pre-workout meals on all days with protein. On arm day, you just don't drink your protein shake. So that is what I'm saying. But I gave an answer for your question. So I hope that answers it. Ayush Rajput asks, what should be the plan if one starts lifting after 2 or 2.5 months break, especially for the college or school going students, as during the exam time, it is difficult to get ourselves to the gym. Now, I'm a little bit skeptical about quitting gym during your exams. Now, I've studied till 12th and also done 2 years of engineering. So, I know how exams work, okay? To be honest, guys, no one studies 24 hours in a day. This is just my personal opinion. And you just need 1 or 2 hours maximum in a day for gym-related work, okay? You would anyways eat food because you are a human being. You need energy to survive, right? So, in my opinion, try to change up your workout routine during your exams. I know exams are important, but 2 months can be a long time. Unless you are injured or forced to be on the sidelines, I wouldn't recommend taking 2 to 2.5 months of break, okay? So what I would suggest is maybe go to the gym 2 times a week or 3 times a week or just hit your muscles so that, you know, they don't go off. Your muscles, you won't lose all the muscle, but you might lose some strength, which you will return, you will get it back via muscle memory. But I wouldn't recommend, you know, you skip gym during your exams. I mean, 2 months is a long time, okay? You can make a lot of gains in 2 months. Indranil asked me, hey Shreyas, just want to know how to get off keto with least water gain. I have a show coming up on 26th of Jan and I'm on keto to strip off that fat. How to load carbs on the day of the show as I'm on keto, please help. So, I made a video with my friend Bharat. You can click right over here, okay? You can check whatever we did during his show. Secondly, bro, like this is my advice for people who are competing. Just my opinion, guys. And I've seen that in India, this doesn't usually happen. Now, let's take example of Christian Guzman or, you know, Matt Ogus. I don't know what is their status, but they are always ready 3 or 4 weeks before the show. Now, you have around 3 weeks for the show, I guess. So, you should have already been ready. You know what I mean? So, you shouldn't be even thinking about fat. You should be just thinking about maintaining your body fat. So next time when you compete for a show, make sure you are ready 3 weeks before the show. At least 5 weeks would be even good, but better. But I think, you know, 3 weeks is a little bit too close. But since you're asking me that question, I think you can come out of keto right now, eat some carbs, start eating carbs right now, increase your cardio. That is the only advice that I can give you, knowing whatever you have given me here. Okay, from whatever the information you have given me, I think you just should come out of keto, add carbs and do some more cardio. Okay, do something that I have not done so far. So I hope it helps, brother, and all the best for your show. I hope that you place well, or if you win, that is even better. Dhaval Jariwala asks, how to get rid of the last bit of fat around waist and lower abs while cutting? My body fat percentage is around 10 to 12%. Good that you are at 10 to 12% now to cut the last bit of fat. Somebody replied that doing keto diet is good, bro. Doing keto diet is good, buddy, but I have not seen how you look. Okay, that is the first thing. Now, 10 to 12%. How do you know that you are at 10 to 12%? Okay, now because you gave me a range, I think you might be at 12%, but because you are not confident that you are at 10%, so I think you should, you know, take a diet break, maybe 1 week. Take a diet break for 1 week. Let your body, you know, restore everything. Start functioning normally, because 10% is not normal for your human body. So just let your body start functioning properly. You must be having all the time in the world. So after the break, start off with the normal diet, like a calorie deficit diet. You might lose weight or you might lose fat. If you still don't, then try principles like carb cycling or, you know, keto diet. So try something like that as well. Okay, this is a very good question. My question is that if I cannot obtain my protein requirements from natural food sources, can I go for 3 scoops of whey protein in a day? Very good question. Now, I am taking 3 scoops of whey now. Okay, 3 scoops of whey, I am using my protein. It gives me 63 grams of protein. I still need around 130 grams of protein. So where do I get it? So I can't get 180 grams of protein from food, guys. Please, I don't like eating so much of food, protein rich food, but that is why I get to take 3 scoops of whey protein. One in the morning, one before my workout, one after my workout. If I'm working out in the morning, one before my workout, two after my workout. So like that, you can use it, not at all. It is just a supplement, guys. So guys, next question is from Paul Babu. In all articles related to nutrition, they provide macro based on weight in grams. My question is, those weights are in cooked form or not? Very good question. I get this question a lot of times. Now, when it comes to things like chicken or, you know, any meat, right? I would always measure it after it's cooked. It tends to lose a lot of water. So if you want to know the macros, you can always find on a lot of websites. But chicken and any meat, I would measure it after it's cooked. Now, rice, again, I would measure it after it's cooked. Because if you cook 100 grams of rice, it will be like some 500 grams or 400 grams or 300 grams, right? So I measure rice after cooked. And also things like oats, I would measure it before it's cooked. And things like this, I would measure it before it's cooked. But meat and all these protein sources, I think I would measure it after it's cooked. So guys, the last question that I'm going to discuss is from TD Vikas. Does Manchester United have a realistic chance of winning the EPL this year? I really hope they continue the form they are at. I mean, we are going through a great form now, but Chelsea is flying, but they got beaten by Tottenham. I mean, assaulted by Tottenham. But let's see how it goes, guys. Like, anything can happen in the Premier League, and we are close to the 4th spot or 5th spot, Arsenal. Tottenham is in 4th, I guess. So let's see how it goes. The match against Liverpool is very important, and I hope Rooney scores his 250th goal. So that's all for the Q&A, guys. I hope that, you know, this video helped you. I'm sorry that I couldn't answer the other questions. It will take me forever to answer. So thanks a lot for watching, and I hope that the lighting was fine. I hope the camera was in focus. And also subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are watching my video for the first time. And I hope that you share the information that I shared with your beginner friends as well. So thanks a lot, guys. Do give it a thumbs up if you liked it. If you didn't like it, you can vote this video down as well. So I'll be back again. Peace out.